and God bless you. Good afternoon. Come on in, people of God. It is the sweet hour of prayer. We want to wish you a wonderful Wednesday afternoon. We pray that the blessings of the Lord are finding you and chasing you and taking over you. If you have a prayer request, you're more than welcome to submit it. You can call us at the church, 281-426-4223. Again, that's 281-426-4223. Please leave your name, your number, and your prayer request. Please know that your prayer requests are kept in the strictest of confidentiality. If you desire to do so, you can also email us at unitybaytown@gmail.com. Again, that's unitybaytown@gmail.com. You can submit your prayer request there. Or you can also go to the website, www.unity-baytown.org. Again, that's www.unity-baytown.org. Go to the Contact Us page and submit your prayer request in the Contact Us page, and your prayer request will be sent directly to me in the strictest of confidentiality. Also, you can go to the social media sites. If you desire to display your prayer request publicly, you can type it there in the comment section on Facebook or on YouTube. Or you can go to the inbox on Facebook, the DM on Instagram or Twitter, or even on YouTube. Whatever mode of your communication, we love to receive your prayer requests. And we believe here at Unity that prayer requests turn into praise reports. So thank you for mixing your faith with ours, and we believe the best for you. Let's go to our prayer focus for today. It's found in Psalm 139. Psalm 139, verse number 23 and verse 24. And by preference alone, we're reading from the New International Version. Psalm 139, verse 23 says, "Search me, O God, and know my heart. Test me, and know my anxious thoughts. See if there are any offensive way in me, and lead me in the way everlasting." Ah, what a request. God knows our heart. He knows what's inside of us. And it is His desire that we walk in the right path. So let's ask Him on this Wednesday to search us and then guide us. Let's pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, before we ask you for anything, Lord God, we want to thank you for everything. Thank you for life, health, and strength. Thank you, God, for another chance to call upon your name. Father, it is a privilege. It is an honor to come before your throne to find help in the time of need. Now, Father, we thank you because we know that we have not been everything that you wanted us to be. We have not said everything. We have not done everything. We have not thought everything that you wanted us to think. And God, over and over again, you continue to bless us. You continue to keep us and provide for us and protect us. And God, we don't take that lightly, but we say thank you. Thank you, God, that you've kept us these past 7 days. You kept us from the last Wednesday until this one. You kept us from Sunday until now. God, thank you that even in the midst of everything that has gone on over these recent days, God, you have been wonderful to us. We don't take that lightly, God, but God, we say thank you. But now, God, we know us. We know that as we strive to live for you, we know that as we desire to walk in your way, that there are some things, there's the lust of the flesh, the lust of the eyes, the pride of life, which causes us not to walk in the way that you want us to. So, Father, we ask in the words of your servant David, search our hearts, search our minds, God. Father, we say as the saints of old, we stretch our hands to thee. No other help we know. So, God, we're leaning on you. We're depending on you. We need you, God. You told us in your word to acknowledge you in all of our ways, and you would direct our path. So, God, we need you on this Wednesday at this hour of prayer, God, to order our steps, direct us. First of all, search our hearts. Test our motives. Test our intentions, our innuendos. And, Father, not if you find, but when you find. Because we know, God, in the words of your servant Paul, there's no good thing that lives in us. So, since, God, there's no good thing that lives in us, test us. try us. See if there be any wicked ways in us. And Father, when you find those wicked ways, create within us a clean heart. Renew within us the right spirit. Don't take your Holy Spirit away from us, God, but lead us in the way of everlasting. Show us what to do. Show us where to go. And Father, when we get distracted by the things of the flesh, God, when we get distracted by the lust of the flesh and the lust of the eyes and the pride of life, God, steer us on the right path. Let your Holy Spirit turn us into the place where we're supposed to go. Whereas we would go to anger and animosity, steer us in the way of peace, God. Whereas we would go in the place of lust, help us to go into the place of integrity and character. Whereas we would go into the place of hatred, give us the way of peace and love. Whereas, God, we would go into the place that is sinful, help us go into the way that is spiritual. Whereas, God, we would go to the place that is not like you, help us to go into the way that is all about you. God, lead us. Please, God, we can't make this journey without you. Don't just show us where to go. Hold our hand. Guide our feet. We need you. And God, we need you now. We need you for such a time as this. God, some of us right now are getting ready to make some decisions. And we can't make this decision without you. Some of us are looking for direction. And we don't want to move without you. We need you, God. We're tired of getting chastised. We're tired of getting our behinds tore up. We're tired, God, of falling on our faces when we don't have to. We're tired, God, of messing up and being defeated even when we don't have to. So, Father, in the name of Jesus, lead us in the way everlasting. Father, we'll be so quick and so careful to give your name the praise, God, and the glory. And it is so, and it cannot be otherwise. In Jesus' name, amen. Hallelujah. The Bible says if you acknowledge him in all your ways, he will direct your path. So we're going to ask God to continue to lead us and guide us and steer us in the right way. God, search us, then steer us. Search us, then steer us. Because if God is ordering our steps, then we can't go wrong. Listen, I look forward to seeing you tonight, right back here at 7 p.m. for our Wednesday with God Bible study. If this prayer was a blessing to you, please share it with somebody who else needs to be steered in the right direction. Can't wait to see you tonight here in this virtual space. Until then, we love you. May the rest of your day be the best of your day. We'll see you here on tonight, if the Lord's will. Grace and peace.